that I would try such fun is a very complex process. To get to know faith and understand it better, we have to find its cause. That's why I'll go back in the history of this thing.
In 1984, there was a huge happening in Sarajevo, Winter Olympic Games. The 1984 Winter Olympics, officially known as the 14 Olympic Winter Games, was a winter multi-sport event. The most beautiful historic moment was when the flame has been lit. Whole world gathered here, and it was then that the whole world was saying that Sarajevo is the most beautiful city, full of great people and, what's most important, safe. Then, a couple of years later, that safety was gone. Something terrible happened. War. It took human lives, but couldn't destroy Sarajevo's soul. The Siege of Sarajevo, as it came to be popularly known, was an episode of such notoriety in the conflict in the former Yugoslavia that one must go back to World War II to find a parallel in European history. Not since then had a professional army conducted a campaign of unrelenting violence against the inhabitants of European city so as to reduce them to a state of medieval deprivation in which they were in constant fear of death. In the period covered in this incident, there was nowhere safe for people of Sarajevo, not at home, at school, in a hospital, from deliberate attack. It is plain that Sarajevo has suffered badly at the hands of its attackers. Apart from the obvious human cause and the continued suffering and difficulties of day-to-day living, there has been serious damage to the urban fabric. The infrastructure is badly damaged. War left great consequences on upcoming generations. Parents don't work and families are out of money. War hatred is deepening. Juvenile delinquency has escalated in all areas. We encounter it on streets, sport events, concerts, etc. Simply said, it became part of our everyday life. Juvenile delinquency, also known as juvenile offending or youth crime, is participation in illegal behavior by minors, juveniles, individuals younger than the statutory age of majority. The high rates of juvenile delinquency often receive great attention from the news media and politicians. The level, amounts, and types of delinquency are used by commentators as an indicator of the general state of morality and law and order in a country, and consequently, juvenile delinquency can be a source of moral panics.
Do you feel safe in Sarajevo?
No, because there are so many teenagers being violent today and they are making problems, and that's why many of us don't feel safe in
Sarajevo. I think Sarajevo is safe because there is not a lot of crime.
No, I don't feel safe because of a huge number of young delinquents.
In every social group, there are people who bounce by their behavior. Every social group reacted on these kinds of behavior with different variety of punishments. Most common type of punishment is isolation of individual whose doing society doesn't accept or approve. In Bosnia and Herzegovina, there is no such a thing as prison for juveniles. They are free to do what they want and no one can punish them because they are under 18 years old. Juvenile delinquency is best showed on football games. The name of cheering groups itself leads on destruction.
Tell me some examples of juvenile delinquency.
The stealing, killing people,
stealing
and street fighting.
Examples: fighting, shooting something, shooting some people, because in Sarajevo the weapon is cheap. Because of that, everybody can buy the some weapon and then they can kill another person.
In Canton Sarajevo, juvenile delinquency is on high level. Some of very disturbing data are: two juveniles poured oil on 72-year-old woman and ignited her. They were 15 and 16 years old. In 2008, in tramway, three juveniles beat it up and stabbed with a knife 17-year-old boy. Last week, one 16-year-old was attacked and stabbed in the arm on tramway station. Police caught committers. They are 15 years old. This city has many good people who came to say last goodbyes to boys who were tragically killed. Largest predictors of juvenile delinquency are parenting style and peer group association. Parenting style, with the two styles most likely to predict delinquency being permissive parenting, characterized by a lack of consequence-based discipline and encompassing two subtypes known as neglectful parenting, characterized by a lack of monitoring and thus of knowledge of the child's activities, and indulgent parenting, characterized by affirmative enablement of misbehavior. Authoritarian parenting, characterized by harsh discipline and refusal to justify discipline on any basis other than because I said so. Peer group association, particularly with antisocial peer groups, as is more likely when adolescents are left unsupervised.
How would you stop juvenile delinquency?
That problem would be solved if there were more adult fosters on the street, if there were prisons for adolescents.
I would implement new laws and build more prisons.
I think it can be stopped because family can give the good education about the cultural education. It can be better. After that, teenagers can be safe, and then there is no crime, there is no happen in this area.
Delinquency prevention is a broad term for all efforts aimed at preventing youth from becoming involved in criminal or other antisocial activity. Because the development of delinquency in youth is influenced by numerous factors, prevention efforts need to be comprehensive in scope. Prevention services may include activities such as substance abuse education and treatment, family counseling, youth mentoring, parenting education, educational support, and youth sheltering. It has been noted that often interventions may leave at risk children worse off than if there had never been an intervention. This is due primarily to the fact that placing large groups of at-risk children together only propagates delinquent or violent behavior. Bad teens get together to talk about the bad things they've done. It is received by their peers in a positive, reinforcing light, promoting their behavior among them. As mentioned before, peer groups, particularly an association with antisocial peer groups, is one of the biggest predictors of delinquency and of life course persistent delinquency. The most efficient interventions are those that not only separate at-risk teens from antisocial peers and place them instead with prosocial ones, but also simultaneously improve their home environment by training parents with appropriate parenting styles. Parenting style being the other large predictor of juvenile delinquency.
Is this city safe? I think that this picture tells all about us.